Hey people, it is Tuesday, which means it is my time to come to you and teach you something as you start, build, and elevate your purpose-centered business. So today's topic, I just want to talk to you about a very dangerous game that I hope and pray that you never decide to enter. And the reason is because you can't win it, right? And that game is the comparison game. So it does not matter how many times I talk about this or teach this to my clients as they're starting, but something, and we build together and we're still good, but something happens when they go from the building phase to the elevating phase and they shift their focus from their own thing, right? Their purpose, their divine assignment to, well, what is she doing over there and how is she doing it? And what system is she using and what tech is she using and what is her application process? Blah, 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 blah. Or the other thing is, oh my gosh, oh my gosh, oh my gosh, my market is so saturated, right? And some of that might be true. But here's the truth. It does not matter how saturated the market is. And the reason is because there's only one you. People are drawn to you. They're not drawn to your tag. They don't care about your website. They are drawn and want to work with you. But here are three reasons why it is super, super dangerous to enter into the comparison game. Now, number one, I already told you, you can't win it. I don't care how good you think you are. You can't win the comparison game. So don't even try, right? So the first thing is, if you get too far down the rabbit hole, right, of going down Google, looking up your competition, spending hours on their Instagram feed, and comparing yourself, number one, you're derailing your own progress. So what I'm saying is, how is it that you expect to move forward and gain momentum and get better and faster at what you're doing if you just spent 3 hours a day on someone else's Instagram feed? You are trying to move your business forward with your head focused over there. It's impossible, right? So the second thing is, you are going to mess around and sacrifice your joy. And so one of the things that I am really, really anal about is, you can't steal my joy. I don't give my power away, and you also are not going to steal my joy. But the moment I decide I'm going to enter into the comparison game, I literally say, here, girlfriend, and that girl doesn't even know me, right? Here, girlfriend, I am willing to sacrifice my joy. And the reason you sacrifice your joy is because when you start comparing, you automatically start seeing yourself as inferior, right? And then what happens is, it knocks your confidence down and it gets a little lower and a little lower. And before you know it, you're in the sunken place. Okay. So please, that's number two. Don't give away your joy. It's not worth it. The last thing is, you are going to mess around if you stay in the comparison game, and you are going to build up one of the nastiest things that happens to the human spirit. And that is bitterness, as well as resentment. And here's why. Because when you're comparing yourself, and like I said, you've already sacrificed your joy, your progress is way over there, you're not focused anymore, you plant a seed within your own spirit of envy as well as jealousy. And then envy and jealousy take root, right? And then they start to build up the weeds known as bitterness, and then you're just resentful. And when you're resentful, you're really mean. And when you're mean, that's really expensive, because nobody likes to work with mean people, right? So that's it. Today, I want you to take a look at yourself, see how many hours you've, or even days, weeks, and months, no judgment. Some of you have been doing it for years, no judgment. And see who you are comparing yourself to, right? Why you are comparing yourself, because here's the thing, there's nothing wrong with knowing your competition. That's a business strategy. You need to know who your competition is. But what you don't need to do is sit and compare yourself to them, especially if they're light years ahead of you. So if you're going to compare yourself to someone, make sure you're comparing apples to apples. You're starting at the same place, not apples, oranges, pears, and some grapes and some mo things. Okay, so that's it. That's my Teachable Tuesday today. If you have any questions, you can drop the comments below. I promise to respond, as well as feel free to DM me, excuse me. Also, I'm going to put a link up top to join my free Facebook group, Purposeful and Prosperous Women. And that's it for today. I hope you guys have a wonderful day. Thanks. Bye-bye.